Hello friends, very good morning to you all. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel, Dr. M.H. Annaya Academy, and myself, Professor M.H. Annaya. Friends, in today's YouTube video, let us learn how to locate the centroid of a Z-section. Friends, the dimensions of Z-section are given, and you can see this is not symmetrical about the horizontal or vertical axis. So we'll have to locate both X bar and Y bar here. And this particular cross section can be split into three rectangles. That is, I can just write a horizontal line here and say this as number one, rectangle number one. Likewise, you have got the second figure here. We will call it as figure number 2, a rectangle 2, and the bottommost is rectangle number 3. So the complete section is split into three rectangles having dimension 80 by 20, the second is 60 by 20, the third is 100 by 20. So all these rectangles have got different areas of cross section. Friends, now to locate the centroid of the whole section, we need to know the centroids of individual rectangles. Let me start with the first figure. To locate the centroid of this rectangle, I can just draw two diagonals like this, and these two diagonals meet at a common point, and this is figure number one. Hence, I represent this as G1. G1 is the centroid of the first rectangle. Similarly, if you move on to the second one, on the same lines, we can locate the centroid of the second figure or second rectangle. I will call this as G2. G2 is the centroid of the second rectangle. Likewise, friends, you can also locate the centroid of the bottommost flange. Say this is figure number 3, this we can call it as G3. So G1, G2 and G3 are the centroids of the individual rectangles of the Z section. Friends, now to find out the centroid of the whole Z section, let us start with calculation of X bar. The X bar is given by the formula A1 X1 plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3, because there are three areas and three rectangles are there, hence we get up to A3. Friends, first of all, let us find out the areas of these individual rectangles. A1 stands for the area of this rectangle. So this A1 is equal to 80 into 20, this is 1600 mm square. Area 2 is the area of this rectangle, which is 60 into 20 is equal to 1200 mm square. Similarly, the last area, A3 of the bottommost rectangle, is given by the formula 100 into 20, that is 2000 millimeter square. Friends, if you add up all these areas, it works out to 1600, 2800, then 4800, 1600, 2800 plus 2, yes, 4800 millimeter square is the total area of this Z section. Friends, let's locate what are these X1, X2 and X3. Friends, this X1 is the distance of this G1 from the Y axis. This is 80 totally by 2, that is 40. So X1 is equal to 40 mm, and then you have got X2, that distance from here to here. Friends, here you can just see here, from here to here this is 80, and you have to subtract 10 from there, so you will get it as 70. x2 is equal to 70 millimeter, and this x3 is from this till here. Friends, you can see here, this is 60 up to here plus 50, that is x3 is equal to 110 millimeter. So we have got all the values of x1, x2, x3 and also the areas. We will substitute and get the value of x bar. So x bar is equal to 1600 multiplied by 40 plus area 2200 into x2 is 70 plus area 3 is 2000 multiplied by this x3 110 divided by this total area a1 plus a2 plus a3. If you add, you are getting 4800 square millimeter. Friends, if you simplify, you get the answer as 76.67. So x bar is equal to 76.67 millimeter. So we are able to find out the distance of the centroid from the y axis, that is called x bar. After calculating this x bar, friends, let us move on to the calculation of y bar, that is the distance of the centroid of the figure from the horizontal axis OX. Friends, here this y bar is given by the formula a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by the total area, which is a1 plus a2 plus a3. Friends, here what are these y1, y2, etc.? Look here, from the x-axis to g1, this is y1. So this total height is 20 plus 60 plus 20. So totally it is 100. If you subtract this value, you will get 90. So y1 is equal to 90 mm. Likewise, y2 is the distance of the centroid g2 from the x-axis. This is 20 plus half of the 60 is 30. So 50 mm. Y2 is equal to 50 mm. Finally, well, of y3 is required. Y3 is from here to here. This is 20 by 2, that is 10. So y3 is equal to 10 mm. Friends, after getting this value of y1, y2, y3, etc., let us make the substitution and get what is the value of y bar. So friends, if you substitute in the formula, you get y bar is equal to a1, that is 1600 into y1 is 90 mm, plus area 2 is 1200. Already we have calculated this, multiplied by y2 is 50 millimeter, plus area 3 is 2000 millimeter square, multiplied by the distance is 10, and total area of this is 4800, that is a1 plus a2 plus a3, that is 4800 is the total area of cross section. So 4800. Friends, if you simplify this, you get the answer as 46.67 millimeter. That is, the centroid of this Z section lies at a vertical height of 46.67. So what is 46.6? Where does it lie? If you want to show it practically on this sketch. So 46, this is 20, this is 30, 50, little lesser than that. So somewhere here, the y bar will lie. It is from the bottom, it is 46.67. And what about this x bar? 76.67. 76, this is 80. So 76 is very closer to that. Maybe going to be somewhere here, very close to. So this is our G, the centroid of the whole figure, which is at a distance of x bar. 76.67 is x bar, and the y bar for this is this gap, which is equal to, say, y bar is 46.67, that is 46.67. This is how the centroid of the given figure can be located. Friends, I hope you have followed the procedure how to calculate the centroid of the given z section. Friends, in the same problem, if these two flanges were the same, that is, instead of 80, if this were 20 and if this were also same, sorry, this is 100 and again 100 like this, then it would have become symmetrical about both the x-axis and the y-axis. I thank you all, friends, for watching my video. Have a nice day.